My dear brothers and sisters, I would like in today's khutbah to answer the question, what is our role as individuals and as a community in this larger society? The responsibility in society is undoubtedly huge and requires a different quality of the human being. Who is this human being? And what are his or her tasks? The first task is inner transformation, which should precede social transformation. Inner transformation precedes social transformation. Inner transformation means working on yourself, and it starts by returning to self and asking the critical questions. Who am I? Where and what I want to be? Inner transformation means blaming nobody for my shortcomings. قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنْفُسِكُمْ. Say to them, it is from yourselves. وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي. Nor do I absolve my own self. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرًا. Nay, man will be evidence against himself, even though he was to put up his excuses. My dear brothers and sisters, inner transformation means looking inwardly to discover myself and becoming aware of my strengths and weaknesses. Inner transformation cannot be delegated. It is my responsibility that stems from the free will granted to me from Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah will not change the condition of the people until they change themselves. It is a continuous and a creative change from the state of becoming, of being, to the state of becoming. Becoming the best I can be. What matters here is the quality of the human being produced from this transformation. The product is a new and a true human being who actualizes his or her humanity and liberates himself or herself from superstition, frozen traditions, and fanaticism. New and the true human beings who understand their own character as created by Allah, with the capacity to be active and effective in this world, and at the same time have the capacity to free their souls from what they have accumulated or achieved. Inner transformation precedes social transformation. The second task, read your society. The task of reading and understanding the characteristics and complexities of a society is not easy. We have to discover our potentials and increase our capabilities in order to acquire a deeper understanding of the society. Sciences like sociology, psychology, anthropology, human geography, history, philosophy of history, and other social sciences provide new tools for such complex endeavor. Collectively, they will allow us to understand the culture or the different cultures of different societies, and even the subcultures in a specific society. This task is the engagement of a witness who should be present every time you hear the word witness, shahid or shaheed. Immediately should come to your mind the word present. You cannot tell a judge in a court that you have a witness unless you bring that witness to be seen by that judge. Should be present physically. And we are saying you need to be a witness in the society, meaning to be present, not only physically, but mentally and emotionally. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. We have truly sent you as a witness, as a bringer of glad tidings, and as a warner. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, or any prophet, or any reformer, before he plays the role of Bashir and Nadir, has to be a witness in his society. لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. So this is at the level of the society, of the community, of the nation also can play the role of the witness over other nations, that you might be witnesses over the nations. The same way the messenger, a witness over yourselves. لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. The objective of this engagement is to discover where the society stands in the currents of history and understand the social realities, the ideas and the institutions in that particular society. This level of engagement will enable us to identify the social problems and bring them to the consciousness of the people. After you identify a certain problem, the next step is to change the social problem into a specific social issue. From a problem to an issue. The issue is more specific. Give you an example. To say, for example, that there is a problem in Lake County regarding mental health is not enough. But when we ask the question, what are the resources available for patients who suffer from mental illnesses, and how access to these resources can be facilitated? Now the mobilization of the community for help becomes easier. So read the society. The second task, read your society. The third task, connect with the people. Our target is the people or the masses. In the Quranic terminology, an-nas. Remember, Quran starts in the name of Allah. Bismillah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And it ends with, what is the last word of the Quran? An-nas, the people. It starts with the name of Allah and ends with the people. This is a book for the people. Hudan lin-nas, guidance for the people. The emphasis on an-nas, or the people, in Quran is very explicit. And we need to contrast that with the concept of elite or amal. Again, another Quranic terminology. It's a contrasting concept or contrasting paradigm. Diametrically opposite. The elite have no interest the people in contrast with the elite have no interest or special agendas. We have to adopt and own their problems and behave as their advocates. Listen to what Quran says. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. We gave him a light whereby he can walk amongst the people. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. It's at the individual level. Again, as a community and as a nation, we can also play that role addressing other people and humankind. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best people evolved or graduated, if you like, produced for mankind. In order to make the masses aware of the social facts, we have to use their language during communication. It is a public language that they understand and it resonates in their minds, not the language of the professional or the propaganda of a special interest group. To master the language of the people is to understand their needs and concerns. I am not talking here about whether I speak English versus Arabic or French or Spanish. I am really talking about how when we speak, we are truly speaking on the behalf of the people and expressing what is inside them. When they listen to you, say, oh my God, this is what I have been thinking about, but I don't know how to express it. Now you are speaking on my behalf. You are speaking my tongue. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the prophets and the messengers. من رسول إلا بلسان قومه ليبين له. We sent not a messenger except in the language, in the tongue, speaking the language of his people. Again, not the language as in the superficial meaning, but they express what is going on inside them, expressing their needs and concerns. Musa alayhi salam was the one who spoke in the palace of the Pharaoh because he was familiar with the protocols of the palace. Harun was with him. But when you read Quran, you see that Musa was talking, not Harun. Because he was familiar with the language and the protocols of the palace. On the other hand, Harun alayhi salam, who spoke the language and the accent of the children of Israel, was an essential asset for the mission of Musa alayhi salam. And this is how Musa expressed that to Allah azza wa jal. وَأَخِي هَارُونَ هُوَ أَفْصَحُ مِنِّي لِسَانًا فَأَرْسِلْهُ مَعِيَ رِدْهَا. And my brother Harun, he is more eloquent in speech than I, so send him with me as a helper. It's very interesting, my dear brothers and sisters, in two locations in Quran. One of them, Musa and Harun introduced themselves to the Pharaoh as Rasula Rabbil Alameen. Each one of them is a messenger. Because they are not the same. Yes, they have the same message, but they are not the same. Not identical. In another setting, they introduce themselves in Rasulu. One, because they have one message. They work in an integrative way. Each one is more specialized, has a special language to address the people around them. But together, they represent the same message. My dear brothers and sisters, adding a new language to your own is a good idea, and it is never late. Speaking the language of the people enables us to work closely with them in order to discover the root causes of stagnation, the root causes of going backwards in reference to their ideas and the principles. This is how we have to measure stagnation or going backwards. In reference to what? In reference to the ideas and the principles. When you see people regressing from being fair and just, you have to stand up and start reminding them. This is how we need to measure or identify the problem. Then work with them to find the right solutions. Shortcuts, premature actions are to be avoided. Every action should run its own natural course, and any attempt to hasten the results may jeopardize such action and may lead to catastrophe. So connect with the people, not the elite. The fourth task, present clear vision needed for social transformation. We need to bring a clear vision to the people. Prophets, peace be upon them all, were successful. Why they were successful? Because they were able to introduce their message to the masses, defining their objectives and the way to achieve that objective. In other words, they gave the people around them the address, the destination, and how to reach that destination. Our mission should not be different. Another example. If affordable housing in Lake County is my objective, I have to state it clearly and work with others who share with me the same objective and put the right steps to achieve that objective. Changing the status quo of society is not achieved by going back in history, but by understanding the movement and the continuation of history. Any attempt to move the masses into the currents of history without such understanding or without giving them a vision will be futile or leads to crisis. Our role, my dear brothers and sisters, is to make tomorrow's history. This is the fourth task. Let me repeat that. Inner transformation should precede social transformation. Then you start reading the society. Connect with the people, not the elite, and present to them a vision. In conclusion, these tasks are the responsibility of a human being who is continuously thinking about himself or herself and also thinking about the society. Every one of us has the potential to be a thinker. Don't undermine yourself. You are potentially a thinker or intellectual, and don't be afraid of that word. You are potentially an intellectual. Once you accept the challenge to be transformed and lead the change needed in society. The intellectual, my dear brothers and sisters, is not measured by the amount of knowledge or the degree of intelligence. Please listen carefully to me. The intellectual is a human being of insight, somebody who can see and predict the future. He has a vision who brings the realities in society to the consciousness of the people and seizes the right moment to change the status quo. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا قوم المستغفرين استغفر الله.